40 years and beyond, charting the course, navigating new horizons in educational leadership is the theme chosen for this year's conference of the National Principals Association. As President Valerie St. Helen Henry points out, the forum is an opportunity not just to celebrate a milestone, but also to reflect on the future of educational leadership beyond the next 40 years.
Our annual conference is a time for where all principals gather to reflect, to receive more nourishment in terms of getting more ideas in terms of what they can go back into their schools and make changes, what they can become better leaders, managers of schools. And I must say, so far, from the chief education officer to the minister and our feature address, we were given a number of things that we need to reflect on in terms of how do we deal with the social issues that are creeping into our schools? How do we deal with the technology and making it become a more useful thing in the school, but in a positive way for our students?
A lot of consideration went into selecting the speakers for the conference, says the NPA president. Among them was Dr. Gail Rigobert, former education minister, who currently serves as the dean of academics at the University of St. Martin. Dr. Rigobert's presentation focused on empowering educational leaders.
One of the things that educators must contend with is the extent to which digital media have taken over our world. Everything we do is digitized, whether it be in entertainment, business, banking, and our own family interactions. And to the extent that educational technology can be fully embraced and integrated into the pedagogic process, that certainly remains a key issue for consideration.
The keynote address was given by Dr. Damien Greaves, a former health minister who is currently a professor and the associate dean for strategic initiatives, continuing education and professional development at St. George's University in Grenada.
As I always say, teachers, principals, we are not the sages on the stage, we are the guides on the side. So if we keep that in mind, what we can do is leverage the opportunity and to flip the script in terms of let the children take command and control of their education under the guidance of the principals and teachers. The principal is the captain of the ship. You want to make sure that there's no mutiny either from the children or the teachers. So there must of necessity be a community partnership with parents, with individuals in the community.
Education Minister Sean Edward reiterated the importance of principals as key stakeholders in the education sector and the government's commitment to working with them to reduce their workload.
Prime Minister Pierre is favorably disposed to some of the recommendations that have been made by the Ministry of Education to his Ministry of Finance in terms of increased allocations for some of our areas of programming. For a while now, principals have been clamoring, particularly at the primary level, about the fact that they do not have secretaries or assistants to help them with some of the administrative functions. We have made that submission to the Ministry of Finance. I've had a personal conversation with the Prime Minister. Things are looking bright as far as that is concerned, but the final word is that of the Prime Minister, who happens to be the Minister for Finance. But I'm optimistic that when PM goes to Parliament and he presents the estimates, that there might be something in there for the education fraternity as it relates to the reinstatement of principals' assistants.
Other presenters at the two-day conference included Dr. Knut Thomas, lecturer at the University of the West Indies Mona Campus, former Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony, and Raheem Joseph, the 2023 valedictorian at the UE Caveville Campus. For the DBS News World, I am Zain Romulus.